Hello, everyone. My name is Jocelyn, and I am an online educator. I currently work for platforms like OutSchool and Cambly, and this channel is dedicated to helping you, both current and aspiring online teachers, find fun ways to engage your learners in the online classroom. So today I'm going to show you a super fun game that I have been using in my own lessons with my own students called Guess the Picture. This is a really fun game that you can create using Canva, and it's a fun tool to practice both vocabulary and sentence frames. So I will show you a few different ways that you can use this game in your classroom with both beginner level students and more intermediate advanced students as well. So without further ado, let's jump in. The first thing that you are going to want to do is to log into your Canva account. Once you've logged into your Canva account, you can go up to the right-hand side and click the purple rectangle that says Create a Design. Click this and go to the presentation option. Once the presentation has loaded, what you are going to do is go over to the left-hand side of the page. Click on Templates, and you're going to want to search Games. This is going to give you a variety of templates that Canva has created that you are able to use for your own classes. So if you're new to Canva, I definitely suggest going over to the templates and just kind of scrolling through to see what they've already created and see if you can relate any of these back to the lessons and games that you want to create for your own classroom. As I said today, the game that I'm going to focus on showing you how to create and give you some variations for is a Guess the Photo game. So I'm going to scroll down until I find the Guess the Picture game. I'm going to click on this template, and you can see that there's actually 33 pages of this game. You do not have to use all 33 pages. If you'd like to use all 33 pages, you can click this button that says Apply All 33 Pages, or you can just kind of go through and figure out which ones apply to the game that you want to create. You can get a preview of each of the different pages just by scrolling down. You can see that they've created several different rounds. They have several different pictures already, and then they also have these cute little additional pages that you can use as a scoreboard. I don't often use the scoreboards in my classes because I have my students working as a team to guess the picture, but you're welcome to take a look through all the different options and see what's going to work best for you and your students. When you want to add one of the slides over into your own presentation, what you're going to do is simply click on the slide you want to add, and then it's going to automatically place it over here. As you can see over here down at the bottom, you can see that this Guess the Picture game title page has been added to my presentation. Then what I can do is I can simply click on any of the text. I can delete any words if I don't want them. I could add any other text that I wanted. I could move these little elements around. I could search for my own elements to add so I can really make it my own. Once I'm done editing this, what I am going to do is go down to the bottom to this little plus sign, and I'm going to click Add Page. This is going to add a blank page that I can then go over here and I can click on the next slide that I want to add. Again, I'm going to take a look, see which features, texts, elements I want to keep, which ones I want to edit, and then move on. So this first page just kind of goes over the instructions. So you could have this as a slide in your presentation, or you could just go over this verbally with your students before the game starts if you don't actually want to add this slide to your presentation. Once you want to add a new slide, you're going to click that Add Page button down at the bottom, and then you're going to go through to the next page that you want to add. The next page that I'm going to add is the game page. As you can see right now, it just looks like a bunch of tiles with numbers on it, but behind these numbered tiles is an image. So the way that you would play this game with students is you would have all of the tiles set up like this. You would have the student guess a number, and then you would remove that numbered tile from the page. You would continue to do this with your students until one of them is able to guess what the image is. That is why this game is a great way to practice new vocabulary, because you can put an image of whatever the vocabulary term is, the students guess the numbers, you remove the tiles, and then they have to say the name of that vocabulary term in the target language. As you can see here, the correct answer would be chicken. But say you're working on different vocabulary with your students. Maybe you're working on school items. So you're not going to want a picture of a chicken in your game. You're going to want something related to school. So all you have to do is remove those tiles a little bit so that you can click on the background image. And you're just going to click on it and then click delete. You can see that that has deleted the image. Then what I'm going to do is go over the left hand bar and click photos. I can then search for the photo that I would like. So I'm going to just search an image for a backpack. And once I find one that I want to use, I'm going to click on it. It's going to auto populate it onto the page. I'm going to double click the image. And then I'm going to click the set image as background. That is going to make the image nice and big, and it's going to take up the full slide. I would then move each of the tiles back to their little spots so that the game would be ready to play with my students. You might have to play around a little bit with the images that you choose, because as you can see, this presentation is in landscape mode. So if I go ahead and delete that background image and clicked an image like this, which is a little bit more vertical, you can see when I double click and set the image as background, it is kind of difficult to tell what the image is. And in this case, you might still be able to tell that it's a backpack, so it might make the guessing a little bit more difficult for your students and a little bit more fun. But depending on how it ends up looking, it might actually be impossible for the students to determine what the image is. So use your best judgment, play around with a few different images until you find one that is best for you and the game you want to play with your students. So I'm going to go back to this image because I just think it's a very nice image. It will be a little bit difficult for my students to guess, because if they choose like the number 1, 5, 6, and 2, it's actually really not giving them a lot of clues as to what the image is. So it's going to make it a little bit more difficult for my students, which should be fun. So this is a very simple way that you can play this game to practice new vocabulary terms. But say you have some intermediate students or some more advanced students and you want to make this a little bit more difficult for them. What I have done in some of my beginner 2 Spanish classes is I have them use a series of different pictures to create a sentence. So we can still use this example of like school items with the backpack, but now I want them to create a sentence about the backpack. So I'm going to review the sentence structure with my students and talk about how the beginning of the sentence, you have your subject, then you have your verb, and then you have, in this case, a backpack. If we're practicing the conjugation of the verb to have, and I want the students to make a sentence about somebody having a backpack, like she has a backpack, I have a backpack, then we're going to have 3 different pictures, one that goes over who the subject of the sentence is, maybe I, he, they, she. The second would be the verb, the proper verb conjugation, and then the third image would be this image of the backpack. I'm obviously going to need a few more slides in this presentation, so what I'm going to do is go back over here to templates. And you can see that it brings me directly back to the template that I was working with before. But now I'm going to want to add a few more slides. So I'm going to add a page down here. And I'm going to actually click this round 1. And because each of these images are going to be connected, I'm not going to say easy round, but I'm going to put kind of the topic of the round, which is going to be maybe the personal pronoun. Or I could maybe put the subject of the sentence, right, depending on exactly what the student has to uncover. And then I'm going to click Add Page. I'm going to click to add one of these, the guessing tiles again. I'm going to remove some of the tiles so that I can see the background image. I think they're llamas or alpacas. I don't want that for mine, so I'm going to delete the background image by clicking on it and clicking Delete. And then I'm going to go to Photos. And I'm going to get a picture of students because the students are going to be the ones who have the backpacks. I'm going to click on the image that I want, double click, set the image as the background, and then cover it up. So what my students would have to determine once they uncover the image, right? They know that they're looking for the subject of the sentence, or they need to state what the personal pronoun is for this picture. So it's a picture of three different people. So they would have to determine that the personal pronoun that they would have to choose is they, right? We're talking about all of those three people. So they would be this personal pronoun we are working with. What I might also want to do is just go over down here to the notes section and then just post a little note about what the image is so that I don't always have to move the tiles to remember what the image is. I can just go to the notes section. So here I would just say three students, they. And then for the first picture that we made, I would write backpack. So then I'd move this over next to round one. And then I also want to just create a answer slide so that once my students guess it, I can go to the next slide and it will confirm that yes, the personal pronoun for this is they, right? That's the first word that we're looking for. I'll then go over to templates, gonna add a page, going to add the round two page. And then the topic for this one, right, is going to be the verb. And if you want, you can say what the verb is, right? The verb is to have, but we're gonna have to conjugate it with they. Your students might already know this, but if they're still learning the different conjugations and need a little bit more of assistance, you can actually have the word behind the little slides. So we're going to add a page, and then we're going to click another round of tile slides. And as you can see here, this one has the numbers 1 through 20. So you could continue to use the slides 1 through 12 if you wanted, but if you wanted to increase the difficulty for your students or practice numbers that go up a little bit higher, you could choose to have more tiles. Again, we're going to pull some of them off. We're going to click that background image to delete it. And then what I'm going to do for this slide is I'm going to add some text. I'm going to click the text button. I'm going to choose the kind of text that I want. And I'm going to write out the proper conjugation for the verb to have when we're conjugating it in third person plural. So right, they have. I would just send this backwards by double clicking on it, clicking send backwards. Could double click and do send it back, and that will send it all the way back. Move the tiles back down. And then I'm going to want to add that answer slide again. So I'm going to go back to template, add another page. I like to use this one for my answer. And so now my students have two parts of the sentence, right? They have dot, 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 because we still have that third picture that's going to lead them to the final part of our sentence, the backpack, right? That's what they have. So I'm going to actually just slide this down. So slide this down. I'm going to add a page. We're now on round three. I'm going to delete the items that I don't want. Topic is the object, right? The backpack that they're trying to find or uncover. And then something that I also want to add here is if you want to make it even more difficult for your students, say you have practiced numbers that are in the hundreds or the thousands, you can go in and change the numbers that are here. So if I just click on the number, I could make this 100, maybe 200. I could go in sequential order like 101 or, you know, 200. You could have the numbers be in order. You could have them just be a whole bunch of different numbers. You know, you can decide the level of your students, what they would most enjoy or what they would get the most value out of practicing, and then choose the numbers that you would like. I'm going to just add one more page because once the students guess the object is in that final picture, they are going to have their full sentence. They have a backpack. And there they have their full sentence. You could change the text in any way you want. Something that I like to do for my students that are either not even younger, but just at the beginning of their language journey, is I like to have the sentence, but then underneath each part of the sentence, I like to say what part of that sentence it is. So for example, I'd make it like all in one line, and then I would put the part of speech or a picture of the item underneath it. So for example, I would go back to photos, and for they, I would have the picture of the three students so that they can remember, okay, they is referring to the subject of this sentence, these three students. You could put the word subject underneath it. You could put an image of like some people as a little reminder. Then I'd go to text, and under the word have, I might put verb, and then under backpack, I could put, you know, it's like the object vocabulary word that we've been practicing. And then I could also just put a little picture of a backpack so that if it is a new vocabulary term and one of my students forgot what the backpack was, they would have a little guide just to kind of help them really understand the meaning of the sentence in case they don't remember what a backpack is, or, oh, if we use the personal pronoun they, who is that really referring to? Oh, it's referring to multiple people, you know, two or more people in this example. So it just gives them a little bit more of some visual cues to help them understand the meaning of the sentence. And there you have it. You can go back to templates and see if there's any other little points you want to add. You can see they do have a congratulations page where you could maybe put a picture of the student who won the game. You can have a thank you for playing slide at the end if you'd like. This is a game resource page, so these are the different images and icons that they use throughout the game. So if you wanted to add more of them, you could just copy the image that you wanted and then paste it to the page that you would want. So that's nice if you want to kind of carry on that similar theme. You could include an answer sheet at the end, so you can really pick and choose which slides you want to use for your particular game. Another option that you can do for more advanced students that might be practicing different verb tenses is you can still go through and have your students create a sentence, right? You know, first they have to figure out who the subject of the sentence is. And then for round two, for the verb, you could have it be, you know, a mystery verb, but you could put the tense that you want them to conjugate the verb in. Maybe you want them to conjugate the verb in the past tense. So they might guess the different numbers, reveal that the verb is have, but then independently, they have to put the verb in past tense. They have to conjugate it themselves after revealing that the verb that they're working with is to have. So that could make the game a little bit more difficult. They'd have to think a little bit more. You know, they're still uncovering what the verb is through the picture game, but then they have to conjugate it themselves. So you could use that to practice the present tense, past tense, future, conditional, subjunctive, if you're working with languages that deal with the subjunctive, you know, depending on whatever the language is you are teaching your students. So that's just another way that you could make this game a little bit more difficult for your advanced students. But I've had a lot of fun with this game. I think it's a great way to practice numbers with your students. You can play around with the different numbers that you choose to make it more appropriate to the level of your students. And then you can simply use it to practice vocabulary, but you can also use it to practice sentence structure, verb conjugation. So there's a lot of differences depending on the grammar concepts that you are learning with your students. And you can do it in a very fun and visually engaging way. So I hope you found this video tutorial on how to create this Guess the Picture game using one of Canva's templates helpful. If you are new to Canva, I do have some other tutorials on how to create other games, as well as a self-guided workshop that you are welcome to join at any time. I will leave the link down below with some more information about this self-guided workshop, and you are always welcome to send me a message if you have any questions, or feel free to comment below. This brings us to the end of our tutorial for today. Again, I hope you found it helpful. Please feel free to leave any questions down in the comment section below. Give it a thumbs up if you found it helpful, and subscribe to be notified of videos in the future. As always, it was fun connecting with you, and happy teaching.